Select committee constituted over medium of instruction bill will meet today. The meet will decide whether MOI bill should be introduced in this session or the next. Earlier, 10 MLAs from ruling had given written assurance to force activists to introduce MOI bill in the winter session of assembly. Though MLAs have different opinions, it seems all will support it. Nilesh Kabral says he will quit the select committee if the bill is not introduced.
The day of meeting of select committee constituted over controversial MOI bill has been fixed. It's on Friday at 5 in the evening. Winter session of assembly begins from Monday. Select committee's meeting on Friday will decide whether MOI bill will be introduced in the winter session or not. Force activists had fiercely agitated demanding conversion of MOI policy into a law. They had even staged an indefinite hunger strike in July 2015. On 1st August 2015, force activists withdrew their indefinite hunger strike after 10 MLAs from ruling government gave written assurance to introduce the bill in the winter session of assembly. Now let us see what these 10 MLAs are saying today. Alina Saldana: if the bill is introduced, we'll see the content of bill before any decision. Mahadev Naik: no comments on bill. Avartan Furtado: will support the bill, decision later if bill is not introduced. Nilesh Kabral: will support the bill and will resign from select committee if the bill is not introduced. Subhash Fardesai says it is mandatory to support government bill. Will support what all 10 MLAs decide. Carlos Almeida: will support the bill. Let us see whether the bill is being introduced or not, said Carlos Almeida when asked what he'll do if the bill is not introduced. Glenn Ticklow: will support the bill. Says bill can be introduced in next session if not in winter session. We could not contact MLA Siddharth Kukalkar, Kaitu Silva and Benjamin Silva. MLA Pramod Sawant's name features in the assurance letter given to force activists, but he hasn't signed it. Right now, all eyes are set on Friday meeting of select committee. Senior reporter Lokik Shilkar for Prudent.
Drishti has begun process for fresh lifeguard recruitment. Drishti management says ITAC and union leaders are fooling lifeguards by giving false promises. Drishti briefed media following indefinite strike of lifeguards. The management has expressed worry over the lifeguards who are not part of the strike but have to stay home fearing trouble from the striking lifeguards. The fresh recruitment will begin soon after the decision. Drishti has moved civil court. The matter will be heard today.
We cannot be forced to employ someone who's got a history of drinking on duty. Now, I mean, y'all tell me, do you want a lifeguard who has a history of drinking on duty? I mean, as a tourist, as a management, we definitely don't. So this is the employment history. Therefore, we have chosen not to employ these people. We have not wrongfully terminated anybody. The union and its leaders are misleading our lifeguards, giving them false promises, and that is the core issue over here. The issue is that this strike is only benefiting those union leaders because they collect subscription from the lifeguards. So in order to increase their earnings, they are misleading our lifeguards to say that we will get you a job, a permanent government job, we will get you 21,000 rupees salary if you all strike.
In that scenario, we went to the court and said we need assistance of the court in accordance with the law of the land to ensure that people who want to work are able to work. And we have been granted an ex-party order restraining the union and 22 other workmen of ours only. And the next hearing of this matter is on 8th tomorrow.
Meanwhile, Vishwajit Rani and Rohan County met the agitating lifeguards. Both have supported the lifeguards and have assured to raise the issue in the assembly.
आणि हे भायले एजन्सी जे येतात आमच्या गोंयच्या भुरग्यांचे वापर करून घेतात हे असले एजन्सी ट्युरिझम डिपार्टमेंटान सपोर्ट करचे नाही कितें कॉर्पोरेशन ते ह्युमन रिसोर्स डेव्हलपमेंट हे सगळे रद्द करूंक जाय जे लायफ गार्ड म्हणतात ते भायर आउटसोर्स करपाची गरज ना तुम्ही मॅनेज आउटसोर्स करू शकता पण त्याचबरोबर खंय ना खंय डिपार्टमेंटाचो खंय ना खंय कंट्रोल असपाची गरज असा सरकारचे लक्ष यांच्या विषयाकडे ओढपाचो हांव असू विजय सरदेसाय असू एलेक्स रेजिनाल्ड असू आम्ही सगळे एकत्र येऊन आम्ही आवाज उठेतले
अँड वेन समबडी हॅज द ऑडॅसिटी टू मेक सच अ डिस्पॅरेजिंग कॉमेंट अगेन्स्ट द सन ऑफ द सॉइल इट अपियर्स दॅट दिस गव्हर्नमेंट इज आयदर कोल्युडिंग विथ सच एलिमेंट्स ऑर दिस गव्हर्नमेंट इज इम्पॉर्टंट टू प्रोटेक्ट द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ द सन ऑफ द सॉइल
गोयकारांक म्हणलं जाल्यार जेही तुम्ही असेंब्लीन
100% काढतो इतल्यात नी की असल्या लोकांक ब्लॅकलिस्ट करूंक जाय गोयात काम करून घेऊन जाय.
Meanwhile, Drishti Life Saving Private Limited has issued advertisement for vacancies of male and female lifeguards in newspapers on Friday. Bureau report, Prudent.
Deputy CM Francis D'Souza has informed that if majority of people suggest Regional Plan 2021, it should be scrapped, then government would scrap it. But if majority of people suggest correction in the plan, then government is ready for rectification and then to go ahead with RP 2021. Government has till now received around 2,000 application for suggestion and objection. 18 January is the last day to file objection and suggestion for RP 2021.
If everybody wants to scrap it, we'll scrap it. If all suggestions say that, scrap it. But if you say correct only this part of it, and he says correct this part of it, and 90% or 80% or 75% or 60% say that, please do this correction, it's okay, rest of it is okay, then we'll move ahead. But if you can resolve this complaint, and if the body of the plan is okay, then we'll go ahead. See, just because I earlier said that, I said it because we received 3,500 objections, then I thought there were a lot of more objections and it would be necessary to scrap it. But now it appears corrections are good enough.
So maximum are corrections?
Yeah, most of it will be corrections.
Let's take a short break. Stay tuned.